Greetings, everyone. Welcome to Twitchy Tuesdays here on EDOstream. I am the host, Seymourgu. Hope everyone's doing well this evening. Just checking out the LFMs real quick. I'm just about to cap. And that's my whole thing for today, is capping. If I can do that, I'll be set. I want to go ahead and do my first iconic reincarnation before the update hits and the bar gets moved a little further. It's amazing when you use potions and put your mind to it how quickly you can get XP and levels. Dog, what are you doing? You're being annoying, rooting around and stuff. Let's put chat up here so I can see it better. Hey, Shu, how's it going? I'm gonna check my ransacks real quick. Oh, good, I have no ransacks. So that will make it easy. Start turning my stuff on here. There. That should do enough. Really, 2 spies and 2 whiz kings, and I should be done. Let's do quick buffs. Oh, I have Featherfallen already, so we'll go ahead and put Celestial Spirit on. I think I've got the boots on. No? The bracers. It's the bracers. Standing at the tides triggering while I'm falling. That's not quite staying in the same place. I'm not moving horizontally though, so I guess that counts.
Blade locking, I should say.
The elephant is up for the next 4 minutes and change. If anybody wants to join on Thelanus. Obviously I'm level 27 doing Spies in the House, which is 20-something epic quest. I forgot to invis. Cool. Yeah, between having elite bravery bonus, doing epic elites, and had a greater slayer pot running for a bit, doing endless slayers in King's Forest, and doing dailies, it's been a pretty quick epic series of levels. If I'd have been focused a little bit more, at least I saw where he went. A jerk. It's that dude's damage down there. I have to go get him. Most of the time when that happens, I don't see it. And then it just sucks because you can't get the extra XP. Should know where he went. And you have to go killing everything. Even then, you may not find him. But see that one green light up there? That's that jerk that I have to go find and kill. So annoying. At least I know it's him. Hopefully I can quickly get through this. Helps if you jump, you know. I didn't open the right one, that's right. Okay. So we'll just do it the easy way. Ha! And miss. That's cool. I really don't like the cooldown on my not quite abundant step equivalent. And I don't like that at all. No idea what happened, where I went. Just not quite on my game for this today. Glad I'm not trying to show off Zerging or anything. Because today it just is not working. There we go. So because I killed the last skeleton, that turned orange and this gate's open now, so I can actually get Plorex for that XP. Isn't a lot of XP, but it helps. It's freebie, basically. Why not? I don't know that I need this, but I'll go ahead and do it anyway. Out of habit. Static walking stick is awesome for that. Same token, it's not going to take me too long to go over here, and since I have the abundant stuff equivalent, it's really quick and easy to come over here and get those breakables for the extra XP bonus. That'll help net me the 10%. Hey Cordovan, how's it going? Thankfully, the timing worked out, and I can actually made it to cap before the next update comes out. So I have this character to go ahead and flag for reincarnation. And I have one other character. I think I'm going to do the same if I can. He was waiting. Ooh, I have a joiner to help if I have my party tab up. Yeah, I'm not sure that my sorcerer is ready to go or not. I can't remember. I think I needed some more Destiny Karma. I don't remember for sure, so check that out after this. The cap here, ready to go. get a third person to go ahead and run this king twice, and that would pretty much take care of the XP, probably. This has been a fun life, though. I've been having a blast with this blade lock. Thanks to Jotmon in the forums for his porcupine build, which is what this is based off of. It followed exactly. The basic concept is there. Just a lot of fun. Very survivable. Although I do need some repair amp. I have noticed epic elites in my points are drained pretty far that I really need some repair amp to get them back up. Keep ahead of the curve there. Other than that, mostly gear I already had. Some gear that just happened to drop in my lap while I was playing. Basically docents. I didn't have any docents stocked up. I'm thinking of running basically the same thing, only making it 10 Paladin instead of 2 Paladin. Get my Paladin past life. Haven't decided yet, but as long as I'm flagged for reincarnation, I should be fine when the update hits. It's the important thing. I'll do that, all that stuff off stream. My rogue is already flagged for reincarnation, so I'm good there. That's going to go into Shade Archai and be another rogue. Definitely stack that up 3 times and then figure out what to do from there. Banked my core stuff I was using that had the extra light spell power for situations like this. We're back on. Refresh some buffs. Hit it. I really don't have to do this, but I will. It'll be nice. I always hate when somebody has wings and I don't, and they fly off ahead of me and leave me to deal with stuff. So I will go ahead and. Just in case they do catch up. So, give them a couple seconds to change their gear if they need to. I did not get it. I thought I got the extra crate. Weird. They didn't want to do another run, which I perfectly understand. Definitely understand not wanting to do, either for ransack reasons or just repetition. But frankly, it's good enough XP that I'm perfectly fine with doing it again. Make sure to invis this time. See if this one goes a little smoother. Jerk. So, weird, got stuck there. Please tell me she doesn't kill. No, she doesn't. Okay, she just kills. I don't care then. That's really bad luck if I had two skeletons dropping in two runs. It's really annoying. I didn't even notice him to join. I kind of like that about the auto grouping. Like, oh, look, somebody joined. I didn't even pay attention. I had no idea. I didn't have to bother with it, it just happened. So just over the head than having to. Alright, let me find the quills, put up an elephant, move left edge, just stab it. Just nice that way. So this should be some good XP. Should get the 30% extra bonus. Guess they don't want to get the extra chest. Which I haven't really seen a lot of people do, so I don't blame them. This is kind of the ideal. We've had no communication. We both know what to do, we're just doing it. I was hoping that'd be better on this new machine, but it hasn't really seemed to be. It's a 2 Paladin 18 Warlock Blade Forged. After this quest, I can link the build. It's Chapman's Porcupine build. Basically, I did some tweaks, but it's that basic build. Why did it work? I would have called it a blade lock, but Porcupine is what Jotmon named it. So. I wanted something different for my morning lock, which is what the warlock I normally play. And I didn't want something as crappy as my half-orc warlock that I have in my static group for my guild, which is just a completely different hey, I haven't tried Warlock or Half-Orc before, and Warlock's too. Let's just roll something up and see what happens. Let them know that we're in and waiting for them. Let's see, here it is, the porcupine build. I think it's this. Yep, no problem. And I can really recommend this build. It has been a lot of fun to play. I haven't had any real issues with it, other than, like I said before, occasionally in harder content, I need more healing amp or repair amp, really. But other than that, it's been a blast. Haven't had too many problems through 15 to 28. Yeah, I really can't think of any problems I've had. It has just been pretty fun and easy. Shinderlin EE. Orchard Slayer. Hey, City. How's it going? And let's see. Devil's Details. Meh. I don't care about that. I think I'll just go run. I mean, look. I've got, what, 88k left? So, Vaughn 3. Not bad, just trying to cap out Shaw here before the update. And I'm thinking a little Vaughn 3 should do it. Not then I can ruin something else. It's not a big deal. And I'll check in with my other character, and I might run one or two, but then I'll be done. Probably going to be a short stream tonight. We have relatives coming in next week. We have a rat that just had surgery yesterday that's recovering, and a whole bunch of stuff to get done by next week. That's why it's kind of and this is really my important thing to get done was this. I blew through I don't know how many levels in just a couple days. I was really surprised at the difference running EE with bravery bonus. Did Stormhorn's Chain, I think most of House P, I don't remember what else it did, but it was really, really fast. I popped a potion and did some King's Force and the Slayers, which got me 600k in an hour. So there was that that helped. That was a nice bonus. I couldn't sleep and I just got up and was like, oh, let's see what we can do here. And ended up doing that and was like, you know, that works. Cost one of the potions I got on a daily roll, no big deal. And Of course, had to have help for that. I was tanking it, so everybody else who came in was doing the killing, and it just worked out really well. I was really happy with that. Epic Stormhorns got me through, I think, 25, 26 mostly. I don't remember. I didn't even use XP pot. I was just using Slayer pot. It was a greater Slayer count boost potion that I used, and it was just amazing. If I'd use a XP pot as well, whew, that would have been, what, 900k in an hour? And that's, you know, some real XP there. Enjoyed that. But I wasn't sure what I was going to do, so I just sort of wandered in there and wandered around, got some of the messages, and got the bonus XP off that. And then as soon as I found the... what is that called? Grim something or other. Whatever the one is, it's the Endless Necromancer with the portal. I changed the LFM to say that. As soon as two people got in and got close, I popped, started killing stuff. I popped the potion, and yeah, an hour later I had my 5,000, I think. And plus, more people came in and they were doing the rares and all that, so constantly getting some bonus XP as well. So yeah, it was really good. Oh, you know, I haven't buffed at all yet. Not that I need to, but it does help a little bit. Yeah. And most of the rest of them, I did dailies like this, you know, Spies, Whiz King, Vaughn, did some Your Barrel Cove. I didn't wander into Wailoon at all. I did Orchard, Epic, last night. It was only EH, but that's really all I needed to get me really close. I think it would have been a lot easier if I had a decent sized guild that had people on when I'm on to run. But, of course, the level and all that. But yeah, I mostly just. Actually, I solo. Except for E. And then I look if there's a group up for EE something. And again, there were the bravery ones. Oh, then I did Vaughn 5. I did EE Vaughn 1 through 4 run, and then I got in. I can't remember if it was EE or EH, Vaughn 5-6, and then I did another Vaughn yesterday, so that must have been, you know, 4 days ago that I did that, because I didn't use a bypass. So, yeah, all that stuff, I mean, the first time Vaughn, the bravery bonus is ridiculous, Vaughn 5, that's just awesome. And, yeah, it just all worked out. I was really happy with the speed. And except for that one potion, well, I popped another potion yesterday in Thunderholm, but that ended up being wasted, which I was really annoyed by. So I went in there, and I found everybody, and I helped kill the emissary, I think. And then, yeah, everybody left and dropped group, and I was like, I just started a pot running, you guys. This sucks. And then I got into the Orchard group, and so I wasted on that, so I had to run everywhere. So, yeah. But yeah, I've been just doing the, what is they call it? The open group, whatever this thing is in the corner here. Where you automatically create a group when you step in a quest. And that's been working out really well for most of the stuff I've been doing. Like this, for example, if I solo it, I solo it. It really doesn't matter. Yeah, I mean, I remember soloing, like, the House P stuff with my owlbear and my panther. And it having to be really careful and slow and all that. But again, my guild, I love them, but it's like five other people who are mostly in the UK. So timing is part of it, plus just the sheer number of people that are on at a time is basically, unless it's a guild knight, there might be one or two others. We have two guild knights that we usually fill up a group on, at least. And I agree, that first life, it's rough. I remember my first life running through some of this stuff, and it was a lot tougher. But this is only my second, heroic life. First iconic life. I do have the 12 epic past lives, though, which help a lot. I will say that. Yeah, I actually get to beat and kill the builders. Have been in groups when I've been running this lately, and I haven't got a chance to kill the builders like I usually do. Because everybody else has got them by the time I get there. I usually get two of the three runes, though, I don't know why. I know. I know a lot of people talk about skill, but I don't think that has a lot to do with it in many cases. I think your build and gear have a lot more to do with it than skill. Or actually, how well you like your build has a lot to do with it too. Foundry, sure. I don't care. Oh, there it is. Didn't get a notice, so this other builder probably isn't here. What? Party member has entered the quest gateway to Kyber and selected the public group option. Would you like to post? I don't understand what you're saying.
Clusters of giant mushrooms grow more sparse as you emerge from the beholder's domain. Ahead, torrents of water point
Because,
to
Shaw's build, the first build that I've had for X years. Oh, I seriously just missed that. Oh my gosh. I haven't missed that in a while. I think that was lag.
Thunder blasts water into the air
Oh well.
nearby. It looks powerful enough to lift a heavy weight.
Really, Shaw's build was just not great. Like I said, Shaw's build was one of those that character, that first build for this character is so old that the build I was following was for the previous enhancement system. So I tried to figure out what was going on. Keep in mind, this is when I get back into the game after being gone for 2 years. It's like, enhancements have all changed. Let's just try something and see what happens. And yeah, I don't think it was very powerful to begin with, and having to convert it to what was actually happening was just when I was out of the game for so long, it just didn't help. And yeah, I went back into the AR, the free AR, and still didn't fix anything. That's why I kept tweaking it every time I epic reincarnated. So I don't think that my skill mattered that as much as the gear mattered. The first time you get epics, you don't have all the gear. And once you get like, Thunderforge level 22, that's a big power jump. And then once you get it level 24 and then 26, those are huge power increases. And when you have, it's slotted with things like Ruby Eye of Erosion and a Meteoric Star Ruby, that all helps. And then having Epic Past Lives gives you the plus 3 bonus. That helps. All that stuff really helps to you more than just, say, skill or twitchiness or even knowing how to play what you have. Because really, Shaw's always been about running in and just smacking the heck out of things with the big axe. And this is pretty much the same thing. It's just now that I have these different, instead of cleaves, I have bursts. But it effectively plays the same way in that regard. It's just that now I can self-heal, and I've got, 10,000 temporary hit points whenever I want them, and I've got all this gear on now because I've got all the Whatchamajigger stuff, the orchard
This
stuff.
great hall is flanked by
So.
towering statues from a lost age. Vale chose a dramatic battleground for her last stand against the inevitable.
Oh, and look, we're all warlocks. Yay. You don't really? I got my first Thunderforge off the auction house. Before I even had the pack. Before I was VIP. I got it off the auction house. That's how I started with Thunderforge, because it was worth it. It was a level 24, it had something slotted in it already. And I played Astral Shards for it, but it was worth it. So. I think I just got the Astral Shards from Monster Manual stuff. I didn't even buy any Astral Shards, I just had them for some reason. So it's possible to do that and get a big target. Before that, I had the off the auction house. I got a what was it? Great Axe, the Chain Soldier. And I again off the auction house, I bought for platinum. I'm talking about the platinum auction house, not the shard auction house. I got that and a couple augments for it. So, and then once I got up to having a couple epic past lives, because I was still first heroic, right? But I got a couple epic past lives set up, and I got a lot more gear so I could actually survive things like just being in Thunderholm, which I really couldn't even survive that well even though when I first went in there. But then it was a lot easier going with a Slayer party, getting flagged for the raids, getting that XP, finding those missives for the XP, and then also. A lot of people didn't need their ingredients, so it was easy to go ahead and grab the ingredients as well. That's why I have 3 4 26 because it's just that good. Now we Dedor. I still want that stupid other axe.
The
The anti
throne
epic
bridge
antique
near
great
the temple
axe.
collapsed.
I still need the last piece for that, and then I'll have a level
Heading for the
21 that I have. I mean, I used
Thunderholm
the.
Ruins.
Obviously, since this isn't an axe specialist, I use my epic sword of shadows on this for level 20 to 22, but then I switch over to Thunderforge because I'm doing that much
Lycanroc
more damage.
Kings have made their home in the shadows of Thunderholm. They
But
seem eager
yeah,
to
for
regain
Shaw, originally I wanted the
control. Possibly
antique great
the
axe and
power
never
of
got
the
it.
Veil.
Yeah, Epic reincarnated 12 times, and then my 12th one, I heroic reincarnated into this build, which is an iconic, so now I'm gonna iconic reincarnate from here out for a while. And having all that epic pathfinder stuff in heroic is amazing. It really is amazing. It's a huge power increase. Huge power increase.
A majestic being of metal and magic glares at you from the
Oh, good, got the rare.
Destroy those who cheat death.
But not the chest. I really think that's the best way to do it for me because I like epics so much more than I like heroics. So putting a lot of the grind in epics up front makes heroics a lot easier. Lot easier. I mean, just like the plus three weapon enhancement is awesome. I've got a plus three to my weapon, which in heroics is a big deal. In epics is not as big a deal, but in heroics that's huge. I mean, you can do that if you want, but if you look at the benefits of epics versus heroics, the best thing that heroic pastimes get you is completionist, but that's a long ways away. Obviously worth it once you get there, but and keep in mind, I'm coming from a stance where I don't really care for heroics as much as I love epics, so that also has something to do with it. I know a lot of people like heroics more than epics, and I like epics more than heroics.
Stand amidst a scene of terrible slaughter. Signs of ancient architecture in the halls ahead.
I mean, for the most part, they're the same. It's just that I like the flexibility of epics, where you can pretty much run any epic at any level you are, and you don't have to worry about so much about bravery bonus. It's easier to get groups up if you do that, like I do. It's just there's some benefits to being epic. Because heroic has such a narrow level range that you can quest with and still get XP or get the bonuses, memory bonuses and stuff. It's just not as fun to me. I don't find as many groups and all that. So. But I also solo a lot. My plan is to Obviously, finish your epic completionist, which I've done once. Do iconics until I figure out. Get everything I want from iconics, I guess. At the same time as I'm doing iconics, I'm getting my heroic past lives. That's the good thing about iconics, you get an iconic past life and a heroic past life. And it also
Heroic
skips,
past life,
15 levels.
you're right, relentlessly
Which,
focused.
once you get to your third heroic life, is a big deal. It's a lot of XP you don't have to worry about.
The locked gate ahead marks the
And what I
end of
did
Marcus
on this
Aurelius.
life was I went and did, 10s, 11s, 12s
You sighted
on
the gate.
elite, and then
Remember the
find
herd
once I
of
had
Emperor serving Drow or anyone
what I felt
else.
like was enough XP out of that, then I went to doing the 13s with the bravery
Oh,
bonus, getting the bravery bonus up and all that. And then I banked levels and ran as much as I could at 15, and then when I capped, I went 16, and when I capped, I went 17, and when I capped, I went 18, and then obviously you never take level 19 unless you're taking level 20 right after, so you always cap that. And that's strictly, like, again, what I was saying earlier, due to the way heroic levels and grouping and bravery bonuses work. That is the only way to do that. You don't want to be stuck at 19 and not have any groups. Hey, Mari, how's it going? Good to see you. Hope you're doing well this evening. And once again, I get all of the. I don't know what it is about these runes that people don't find.
clusters of
But,
giant mushrooms grow more sparse as you emerge from the
yeah.
beholder's domain.
I normally get two or three of them.
Ahead, torrents of water plunge into a pool
Let's see if I screw up this
below.
jump this time.
If you leap into
I
the
say jump, but
waterfall,
it's not a jump, it's
there's
just a
no
fall.
turning back.
And it took me a while to master this, even though it's really simple.
Guide
Good,
me
Mari.
across the
Glad to hear
water.
it.
Air nearby.
Hope you got good
Tolerance.
XPs or loot or whatever you're after. Favor, completions. I am just about to cap, which is my goal. Get this first iconic life in before the updates hits and I have to go to 30. Figure after I do all that stuff, maybe then I'll try a straight 1-30 run. But this moment, I don't plan on doing one of those anytime soon. There's my level. That is what I
Remembering
needed.
statues from a lost age, Vale chose a dramatic
Oh, good.
battleground for
Not
her
far behind.
last stand against the inevitable. So yeah, there we go. Well, actually, I should go ahead and, because this is something I forget all the time when I'm doing epic reincarnations, is I forget to actually go and take level 28, and then I'm trying to reincarnate, and I have to come back here and, yeah.
And what was the last one? Hellball. So I'm supposed to take. Sure, why not? I never did use Ruin. I'm not going to use Hellball because I'm going to immediately Iconic Reincarnate, but there we go, build's done. I don't even think I have a decent. Yeah, I don't even have a decent plus charisma item on. That's what I like about this hybrid build. I don't really have to concentrate on a single stat if I don't want to. Obviously, charisma, strength, and con being up is good. Stormhorns. I had a bailout, unfortunately, before what goes up. I really would have wanted to run what goes up on EE. But didn't have enough time after we did the other ones. I had to get other stuff going. So, oh well. Maybe next life we can do that. Check this stuff. Well, I have charisma if I want it. I don't want it at the moment. Done at the moment. And I have my hat, don't I? Yeah, there's my hat. So, with that and that, I'm ready to go ahead and reincarnate. So, I'm gonna check out, let's see. I'll do this real quick while I switch characters. And we may. No, I don't think our warlocks are ready to go yet. I think our warlocks are only 25. So that's probably what I'll play. The first to level 30 will be my warlock. Our static group, other static group's moving too slowly. But our warlocks are blazing through pretty fast, so I think I'll probably play levels 29 and 30 for my warlock first. Obviously not on stream because my guildies don't care for the whole streaming thing. Even though I actually did stream them the other day. Alright, there we go. Before I forget, Dragon Kim is going away. This or next week will be the last week. Dragon's being given away to somebody for Christmas because we're not spending enough time with him, and they will spend a lot more time with him than we do. So, yay. Alright, so let's see what we've got here. Oh, no, I've got the karma for it. Alright then. What was I doing? Oh, I was trying to get over at least to Shirati before I reincarnated. That's what I was trying to do. I figured, hey, if I get Shirati, then that sets me up to be more powerful at lower level and gives me access to Primal fairly quickly so I can get Cocoon and be more survivable. So that was my plan here. Now I remember. Is there any groups going on that we can maybe join up on? Man, there's nothing really I want to do. And this character in particular, I have a problem soloing with. It's a gear problem, pretty much. I don't have all the gear I need. My spell power is only 397 for fire and 301 for acid, and that needs to be like 200 points higher for each. At level 28 to really do damage. So like Shinderlin away, Orchard Slayer, I mean I probably could hang in there for a little bit. And Thorn and Paw. If I had caught them at the start of the chain, I probably would go there, but I didn't. So I guess I could go to Orchard and do that. I guess. Just to run for a little bit longer. Because I feel like, what am I on now? I'm barely at an hour. So let's do a little bit of Orchard Slayers, and then we'll call it. As I said, I've got a lot of other stuff to do, but I did want to get Shaw up to cap, and then I do want to do this. Get this character up a little bit. How far away are people? Looks like that way's the better way to go. I need buffs on this character. I cannot do without buffs. Yeah, I mean there's time and situations where or times where you can do good stuff on any character with support, especially. But a lot of times on Shaw, I had a real hard time soloing that first life. And even just doing any EEs was, it was a miracle if I didn't die. Like, even on this incarnation of Shaw, that is a lot more survivable. I've had moments of, oh my gosh, I'm gonna die in EE. And that's when I was looking at, hey, you know, I really do need my, Sorry, I'm trying to concentrate here. I'm switching characters and, classes and trying to survive. It's not always the easiest thing to do. And 3K. Woohoo. Targeting anything. That doesn't help. Yeah, and also, you know, if you're in a group, coordinating with your group and understanding how to play with your group, everybody's roles and stuff also goes a long way. It's not good to just Leroy everything, generally speaking. And boy, could I use evasion on this character. Ah! Speaking of evasion, let me get the heck out of here for a minute. Heal up. Know, I was thinking about trying a Vanguard Paladin build. For Shaw's next life, try something like that and then mix it with Warlock and see what happens. jerk. Yep, Mara, that's what I like about my guild static group is that we know everybody's like we know that the favored soul isn't necessarily going to heal us, and we know that I'll go off and Zerg stuff, and we know that somebody else would do CC sometimes and not others, and we know the ranger will aggro things from halfway across the map, and you just get used to things. How everybody plays, and it's really good, fun stuff. We've been playing together for a year now. I don't remember how long it's been. Something like that. Those same characters once a week for a year plus. And that's a lot of fun. It's a fun way to play. Highly recommend a static group. As something different from your day to day. Where is the earth shattering kaboom? Nice. Yeah, the guilds that I ran with that long ago, except for the one I'm in now, which I really didn't run with as much because I wasn't in their static group at the time. They're long gone. I don't even remember the names of those guilds that I was in at that time. Exactly, City. Oh, I'm also heal scrolls. I was going to say, I go through so many heal scrolls on this character, it's ridiculous. Featherfall somewhere, I think I do. Whoa, that's not what I wanted to do. Oh, hello, guys. Night, Mari. Hope you sleep well. Thanks for stopping by. I'm not even really paying attention to my slayers here. Going pretty well. As far as I can tell, anyway. I need a shrine shortly. I thought there was a thing in that one. I guess not. Supposed to be an 8. Why did they not go? Because I'm on the wrong freaking thing, that's why. I really should have grabbed a Slayer pot if I was going to do this. Do it right. We're getting lots of the randoms, which is cool. Not getting very many of the journals, I don't know where they are. I don't feel like pulling up a thing in another window. Okay, so when I did a firewall there, why didn't it work? There we go, that's better. What is it with everything in here having that meteor swarm? Oh, look, a quell. Jerk. He's hiding me in that rock. Which side are they going to aggro first? Oh, minus 12 points. It's a problem. Hey, look, there's a shrine. My priority needs to be getting to that shrine. There they go. That's nice, it's hitting me through the shrine. That's pleasant. Can you please do the rest at the shrine that's right in front of you? Oh man, this Quell's gonna come up and hit me, isn't he? Oh. There's always somebody, some jerk. Can I please rest at the freaking shrine? Now what's hitting me? Seriously, where's that even coming from? Looks like somebody took care of whatever it was. Yay, spell points. There's no sense in healing if it ain't any spell points. So, you know, 6 scrolls of heal. I'm really close to level. If I just get a couple more of those things, maybe I should look those up. Realistically, I'm not going to get the Slayers, but I could quite possibly get the what's names? Missives and stuff. Oh, that hurt. That hurt a lot. Ow. I session. Where's the quill? Oh, they popped up there. How about that? That's what I think you're doing on tops.
My father was a dragon remembered only as the Emerald Claw. Because they loved
that takes me within 8k.
Because they loved me.
Three more misses, maybe, and I'll have it. Together.
And the elves and the dragons did unite when they
I can use some damage, it's just not ideal. Run out of spell points quickly if I'm doing a lot of damage. Need that extra spell power so I can use fewer spells.
It was hatred that finally bound the elves and dragons together. They called me an abomination.
Two more of those.
Dragon, half elf, and branded with a dragon mark of death more powerful than any the world had ever seen. So they came for all of us. They hunted down every elf who bore the dragon mark of death, completely destroying House Bowl. I saw my mother slaughtered. They hunted for me, too. They never found me.
Why does that work like that?
The child they searched for was already dead.
Come on, chillins, come on, my fires. I hate messing with those. It's expensive.
She said she was so sorry. So terribly sorry. It was the only way she knew how to save me.
Fortunately.
They had destroyed every living thing that bore the dragon mark of death. And so it followed that I could not possibly live.
We're resetting.
But there were other ways, she said.
Alright, so for resetting.
And I must trust her. I could not live. But for the sake of our legacy. For the sake of the blood of Vol. I must... endure. Until my mother, my own mother, made me into an undead lich.
Yeah, I never listened to these before. It's kind of interesting. Back in. That hurt pretty quick. Why am I getting hit with that? I have night shield on. Yay. There's my legendary dreadnought rank. Level 3 rank, whatever. Dude just knocks me down with that blast. That's most of See, that took me, what, 5, 6 spells to cast? Oh no, city, I have to go out. I just like having to go out when I'm planning to stay in. There's a red name out there. Isn't that awesome? Very interesting. Do you go first? All right, so you see ya. Hey, Big Sugar, how's it going? Need a shrine. How far away is a shrine? I have no idea. Oh, yeah, okay, here's a shrine. This will be good. I knows where we are now. And it's even clearer, how about that? Hey, Titan, how's it going? I think they're calling it. I think I will too. I think that put me over the hump for Legendary Dreadnought, which is good enough for tonight. I have stuff I need to do. Yeah. So as I said, short stream, but hopefully amusing. Thanks everyone for watching. Let me get out of this party, and I'm going to head back to the ship real quick. But other than that, I may try for a couple more levels on this, or levels of some destiny on this character. I may not bother, I don't know yet. But Shaw was the real important thing. So I've got two characters ready, and this one that's impossible. So, thanks for stopping by. I appreciate everybody watching. Hope you had fun. We'll see you next week. Yeah, probably see you next week, then Tuesday. I may be playing tomorrow on my personal channel. We'll see. And thanks, take care, and good night.